Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I want to talk about some quirks with bookmarks and just explain a couple of things. We've had some interesting scenarios that came up, and so I wanted to highlight these in this video. So enough of all this talking, you know we like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. Here's a scenario. We wanted to use the bookmark navigator to slice and dice a pre-selected set of things from a bookmark perspective. So in this context, I'm using the state province field, and from a filters pane in the bookmarks, I've pre-selected what that should be. And so if I select Georgia, it's going to be Georgia in the state province. So one thing right off the bat that you need to understand with bookmarks and the filter pane, if you choose all visuals, it will take filters on this page as part of the bookmark. So bookmarks themselves will save the filter data. So if data is selected in all visuals, it will grab any filters that you put for filters on this page. Whereas if you've chosen selected visuals, the filters on this page will not be maintained. So that's something right off the bat that you need to be aware of. And I think that's part of some of the confusion that's here with bookmarks when certain parts of the filter pane is actually included in the bookmark, even though I've checked the data option of the bookmark, which includes filter and slicer data. Because I've chosen all visuals, I can use a filter on the given page. Now, if I select a visual here and you'll see filters on this visual, if I were to choose selected visuals, I'd have to do it on the filters on this visual area, not on the filters on this page. Understand which option you've selected, and then that determines which part of the filter pane will be honored. If you do want to use the selected visuals option, you would have to go a slicer route and then have that slicer or visual selected as part of the selection for the bookmark. I know that can get a little confusing. So for all visuals, you can use the filter pane to filter on this page. If you want to maintain a collection of visuals and be able to filter that collectively, and you choose selective visuals, you've got to go the slicer route instead of the filter pane. You can still do the filter pane, but you got to set that up for each visual, and that's not efficient. All right, so that was the first part. And so here, I'm slicing by Georgia, I'm slicing by Texas. You can see here the state province is Texas, and then here I'm saying Texas and red, right? So I've set two items on the filter pane, and that was one of the requirements that we were presented with. When I choose that Texas bookmark, I want it to ignore any filters on color and always show every color, regardless of what else is filtered. The challenge here is that you can't do like that type of specific exclusion like that from the bookmark perspective. The bookmark can only save the state. It's like a snapshot. So whatever you've defined on the filter pane is what it's gonna grab, and it's not necessarily gonna ignore any other filters that are coming into play. So let's go look at how we can do that. If I just go back to Texas, you'll see that my total sales amount is about $20,000. If I go to Texas in red, you'll see it's only $425. Okay, so this is every color that's in there. So now let me go ahead and filter the color. Remember, I said the requirement is that regardless of what we choose here, we basically want sales amount to ignore this. And so I'm going to choose black, and you'll notice my total sales amount is not changing, but look at these other items. So those are definitely being affected by any type of selection here. So that's cool. How did I do that? The magic here, you guessed it, DAX. I'm controlling this through a measure. So I'm basically saying in that measure, just ignore whatever's filtered on that color column. That's it. And so if we go look at the measures that I'm using here, I'm using total sales, all colors. And you can see here, what I'm doing is remove filters. So I'm saying calculate, grab the total sales amount, and then remove filters on product color. So no matter what I choose in this color filter pane, this amount will always stay static. Bookmarks are powerful. Bookmarks are amazing. I love bookmarks, but you have to understand what they can do and what they can't do. And from this case, we need to employ a little DAX to help us along that way. And then what you can do is maybe you have two different visuals, one using that specific measure that's ignoring the filter for that one column. And then you have another visual that's a duplicate visual that's using the other measure that will accept that filter. And then you can swap those different visuals in based on which bookmark you want. So there's lots of creative things you can do there, and what I call tinkering with these items to get you all the way for your requirements list. All right, let me know in the comments what you think. Have you encountered this? Is that how you're kind of going about it? Do you have another option that's maybe available for you? Let us know in the comments. We want to hear it. If you want to see more great content from Guy in a Cube, check out the recommended video above my head. It will be amazing, I promise you. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.